गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी डूइंग एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 15 व्हिच इज रिलेटेड टू जावा नेटवर्किंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स। हियर इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वी लर्न अबाउट यूआरएल क्लास एंड यूआरएल कनेक्शन क्लास एंड विल सी व्हिच आर द डिफरेंट मेथड्स ऑफ दीस क्लासेस एंड हाउ वी कैन यूज देम। नाउ व्हाट इज यूआरएल? यूआरएल इज नथिंग बट अ यूनिफॉर्म रिसोर्स लोकेटर। इट हेल्प्स अस टू स्पेसिफाई एंड एक्सेस द पर्टिकुलर रिसोर्स, एनी फाइल, एनी कंटेंट्स व्हिच वी वांट टू एक्सेस। By specifying the path, by specifying its URL, we can read the contents. So the resource which we are accessing can be available at the local machine or it can be available at a remote machine. Suppose you wanted to access the examination circulars of MSBT. So for that you specify the entire URL mentioning which is the site name MSBT. Now under which section you want to access, under examination section you wanted to read what, you want to read the notices. So you specify the complete path. So URL consists of four components. One is the port number, other is the host name, third is the protocol, and fourth is the file and the detailed path. Out of these four components, only one component we generally use, which is the host name. What we write, what we do, we generally write the msbt.org. So we once entered into the site, we click on multiple links and then reach to an exact resource where what we needed. But if you exactly know what is the path of the circular, what that notice which you want to access, you can write that path in the URL and you can directly land up to that page which contains your desired information. So URL, with URL you can specify the exact path also. So with URL class we can actually access the files which are available on the internet and we can read their contents in Java program. So whenever through a Java program you want to reach to any website, you make use of a class URL and URL connection. So quickly we'll see the constructors and the methods of a URL class and we'll see how to use this URL class and how to access these methods. As I mentioned earlier, the URL consists of four components, which is protocol, host name, port number and file. Now protocol is generally, when we use internet, the protocol used is HTTP. Host name varies because sometimes we need to use access MSBT site, sometimes we want to use Google, sometimes we want to use Amazon and other sites. So host name will vary based on your requirement, but the protocol remain will be HTTP. Similarly, the port number associated with HTTP is 80, and the file, string file, is the entire path of the file which you want to access on that website. So the first constructor consists of all these four components. Now look at the second constructor. This also contains all the things, but the port number is missing. The third constructor requires only string. So you can in double quotes write www.google.com, that's it. But all these constructors throw a exception, which is malformed URL exception. This generally happens if we by mistake write some details which are incorrect, like in google.com by mistake you have written GOOOOO Google spelling, or .com ki jagah if you have written .org. So if any of the mistake happens in the URL which you are specifying, then the exception occurs. What is the exception name? Malformed URL exception. And there are certain methods like get host, get file. So they will, these methods will retrieve the components of the URL. Like suppose if you want to access the port which is used for this URL, so you can write the method get port. If you want to know which protocol is used, then you can write get protocol. So here are the different methods. Now we'll see the program and we'll see how these methods are used there. So here is the program which will help us to see the demonstration of a URL class. As this is related to networking, we are using the package import java.net.star. The class name I've used here is a URL demo. Within the main method, so we are writing public static void main. As the URL class also throws an exception, we'll be writing the constructors and the methods inside the try block. So here is the try block which is starting. Within this, we'll write all the code. So the first step, what we'll do, we'll use a constructor, means we'll create the object of a URL class. So here is the URL class name, and this is the object name, small URL, equal to new URL, and in double quotes I have specified this. So it means I have used the constructor 3. I'll show you quickly. See, I have not used first two constructors, rather I have used the third constructor, wherein in double quotes I am specifying the URL. I am not separately specifying each component, HTTP, protocol, port, domain name, file, rather I am within double quotes I am specifying the URL. So what URL I am passing? http://www.java.com and this. Now with this URL, I want to know certain components, like I want to use which protocol is used. Already we can see which protocol is used, but still if I want to explicitly retrieve which protocol is used, which is the port number, which is the file. Port number is not mentioned here, so you can check what output we'll get. You know, the protocol is HTTP, host name is www.java.com. Port is not specified here, so let's see what output we get. And file name is Java Tutorial. So with the object created, this small URL, with this object we'll call all the methods. So system.out.println protocol URL, URL dot. What I want to know? I want to know the protocol. So get protocol. Next line. What I want to know? I want to know the host. What is the host? Is the java.com. What is the port? We'll see. What is the file? Get file. So get protocol, get host, get port, get file. We'll retrieve the details. Out of which the three things are mentioned in the URL. Now the fourth thing is not mentioned. So we'll see what output we get. So quickly I'll compile the program. So it is compiled. Now I'll run it. So here you can see the output. Protocol is HTTP. Host name is www.java.com. Port number was not mentioned by me in the string. So for that, the missing component is port number. So for the missing component, the method returns -1. Because in the URL which I have specified, I have not mentioned the port number. So in the output, I'll get -1. And what is the file name? File name is Java Tutorial. So these are the four things which I have retrieved from the URL which I have specified. Protocol is HTTP. It is provided. Host name java.com, port number not mentioned in my URL, so we get the output -1. Remember this thing, whenever you don't specify any component of the URL, for that component you'll get a value -1, and file name is Java Tutorial. So this was all about URL class. In the next video I'll show you URL connection class, wherein you'll connect to some of the website and you read the contents of that website and print those contents in your Java program. So we'll see the next program in the next video.